All right, so let's do our last batch of problems here. And these are mixed. I kind of like these because they involve a little bit of everything. So I'm going to write this whole thing out here. You got negative 3 minus 1 plus 7. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to rewrite any of the subtraction parts that are not the first term as addition problems. So negative 3 plus negative 1 plus 7. And then what's nice about these is you can choose to do this kind of in whatever you want, because this now is one big addition problem. And the commutative property tells us that we can add up in whatever order we want. So if I want to do 7 and negative 3 first, or 7 and negative 1 first, or if I want to do negative 3 and 1 first, it doesn't matter. You can do it whatever order you want. For simplicity purposes, I'm going to go left to right. So I'm going to do these two first. So negative 3 and negative 1, they are both the same sign, right? So you would just do 3 plus 1, which gives you 4, and then you keep the common sign, which is negative. And then that whittles this down to negative 4 plus 7. These are different sign from each other. So you would do 7 minus 4, which gives you 3, and then you take the sign of the larger of the two numbers, larger absolute value. The larger absolute value one is the 7, and its sign is positive. So you wind up with 3. And you can always do these on a number line too to like check your work and see if you're doing it right. All right, I didn't want number 14. Why did I do that? Oh, I want 17. There we go. Okay, let's try another one. Negative 5 plus 7 minus 3. All right, so let's rewrite this minus 3 as an addition problem. So negative 5 plus 7 plus negative 3. Now I can move things around. So let's do negative 5 and 7, positive 7 first. So we're going to subtract 5 from 7 because that's the order we do it in. We get 2, and then it takes on the sign of the larger of the two numbers. Well, the larger number is 7, so that's positive. So you have 2 plus negative 3. And then same thing, we'll do 3 minus 2. That gives us 1. And then this has the larger absolute value, so we're going to take that sign. And our answer is negative 1. Sweet. Last one here. Okay, it's too bad none of these have double negatives. That would be kind of fun if we had something like that. All right, so we got negative 9 plus 1 plus 3. This should be pretty simple. Everything's written out the way we want. This one, let's break rank, and let's do this part first. Let's do 1 and 3. Let's add those two together. So we have negative 1 plus 4, okay? And then with this one, just do it as a subtraction problem. 9 minus 4, and that gives you 5. And then take the sign of the number with the larger absolute value. So the larger absolute value is 9, and its sign is negative. So your answer is negative 5. And then just to show you, you know, kind of a working model of this is if you take, you know, and you decide, okay, I'm going to make a number line here, right? And I'm going to start at negative 9, which is right here. I'm going to go to the right 1 unit. Well, that puts me at 8. And then I'm going to go another 3 units. So 1, 2, 3. So that puts me at 5. Sorry, that should be negative. And that puts me at negative 5. So hopefully you can see that there is a way to figure this out if you forget these conventions. But I hope you don't forget them because they really are super useful. All right. I think at this point you are ready to do some practice, and then after that you're good to go for working on multiplication and division, which is much easier.